Hi guys, welcome back. This is Jessamine of Jessamine Creates, and today I am showing you these beautiful tulips that I bought 2 days ago. And it's almost spring here in the Netherlands. As you know, Netherlands is known for tulips. You will see this everywhere in the springtime, and I thought like it's nice to sketch this time to welcome the spring here in our country. And the tulips don't really last too long. Normally they have 7 days and then they'll lose their beauty. So I thought like I'm gonna sketch this immediately before they lose the beauty. So normally when the tulips open like this, it's almost reaching the depth. And yeah, I just want to sketch it before that happened. I'm using my Koval sketchbook here, I first sketch with pencil, but I will first show you the basic technique on how I make the flower. I'm gonna show you the easiest way and also the material that I use here. And on making a botanical flower, loose flowers, you only need these brushes, some round brushes, an angled brush, and flat brush. That's it. You don't need a lot of it. And it's also okay to use a synthetic brush, but I prefer also to use a sable brush for this. Okay, prepare also your watercolor and also watercolor paper for this project. And if you want, you can also draw first a round oval form for the tulip and also some lines, basic lines for the leaves and stem. But I didn't really do it here, but if you like, you can also do it. So first, I'm going to do my flat brush. I'm going to use my flat brush here. As you notice, I twist my brush, and I also actually using both sides, the flat area of my brush and also the side area of my brush. To use that, you need to twist your brush. If you're using a flat brush like this, you need to twist your brush. If you also, by the way, have a filbert brush, I didn't show it here, but if you have filbert brush, that's much better. The filbert brush is actually with round point, but it's also flat, and this one what I have here is just a flat brush. Okay, so it's like that. You just have to twist it and then blend the color. You can use it also the side part of the brush and just drag it to the lower part, and also put pressure a little bit on top and then less pressure when you go down, slowly when you go down. Then you also have thick and thin line at the same time. So the point of the brush, my flat brush, take note, my flat brush, the point of it, you can also use it as a line. So you need to really be careful not pressing too much pressure on your paper. And this is actually works really well when you have watercolor paper. And also for the leaf of the tulips, normally tulips leaves are more like long leaves. And you can really use the flat brush for this. Just drag it first, and then once you're reaching the top part of it, so it's more pointed one, you can just twist again your brush, and then you get a nice point. And also for the next one is my angled brush. This is a really bit difficult brush if you're not get used to it, but I really love this brush also because of the shape. It's so versatile that you can use a thin part, the pointed part, as a line, and also the broad point as for thick lines. The same thing with the flat brush. You can also twist the area that you want to make it thicker, and then slowly twist your brush to get that thin lines. So it's a matter of practicing here. And I know if you know how this technique, you will get a beautiful leaves and also petals on your tulips. And now I'm switching my brush. I'm gonna show you again another brush, and this is round brush, medium round brush from Winsor & Newton. And as you can see, the side part of the brush is also perfect for tulips. You know, the tulips didn't open yet. You know, that's close. When you buy tulips here in the Netherlands, they're all closed, and after 3 days they open. So this one, what I'm making here, is just young tulip, so it didn't open yet. And you can also use the round brush for that. The same thing, you just put pressure and less pressure to get thick and thin line. And then also from the thin brush, from the round brush that I have here now, by the way, I already switched a brush here. If you see, it's more thinner. It's for details. I'm using it for details. So if you notice it for the end, for the whole video, I already using my thin brush for the details like lines and textures of my tulips. And this is optional if you like. If you like to have the like nerves or something like that, or lines on your tulips, on your petals. But if you just want to keep it more loose, you don't have to use this one. I just like to play along with this. And I just want to show it to you, how did I do my sketch before I really go to the whole project, because it was a time lapse and I thought like it's much easier for you guys to see it. How do I do this? So this is the basic way on how I do my tulips. And all along I just play with the color layering. It's the same thing, it's just the basic color, like you start with big to small, and then with painting you just start with light to dark. So that's the basic thing with painting, on my painting techniques. So this is the basic way on how I do my flowers. And if you're interested, try it. Show me on Instagram with hashtag Jessamyn Creates. And after this, you're gonna see the time-lapse video on how I made my tulips on my sketchbook from Koval. Okay, have fun. And I hope you like the video, the time-lapse. And I'll see you in the end of the video. it's finished. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope you like it. And if you have some questions, let me know. And if you have any ideas on what to sketch next, let me know. By the way, the upcoming video is very fun. It's 1 week 100 people challenge, so I'm gonna post it also on my upcoming video. Thank you guys for watching this, and I hope you like it, and I'll see you again next time. Follow me on Instagram at Jessamine Creates, and also here on my YouTube channel, Jessamine Creates. Please subscribe and share it to your family and friends who you think you may be interested to sketch tulips with me. Thank you, and have a nice day. Bye.